Who are you? Can you introduce yourself, please?
I'm a student. I'm May. I'm 12 years old. I'm learning in Larva School, and that's it.
Yeah, cool. What have you been up to recently?
Nothing much. It's nothing much. It's really important.
Anything you want to add?
No.
Well, what would you say are your major problems that you face?
In traffic. Number one is probably people keep pressing their horns.
Horns, yeah.
Yeah. And probably passing the red light.
Okay, so how are you going to solve these?
If technology can pass this limit, then to solve the problem of people passing the red light, I would have a laser barrier in front of the red light.
Yeah.
And then if anyone passes it.
Okay. I hear you.
And the first problem was that people just keep pressing their horns is, just close all the windows and basically make it thicker so it would be harder for us to hear. And earphones.
Yeah, so simple. Okay, so you're gonna choose one stereotype. Do you want to do from the males or the females?
Yeah.
Cool.
I would choose probably number one.
Number one? Okay.
Wait, no. Yeah. So
what is it?
What?
Can you read it?
Men are more interested in women interested than women in gadgets like phones and tablets. So in my class,
yeah.
my friend that sits in front of me, is a really big gamer. He's a really big fan of gaming. And besides gaming, he loves the game performance, which depends on the gadget, the computer. And every single day, he would go around and talk to me about what is going on, and invite me to a game. But then I say that my computer isn't strong enough to play it, or I don't have enough space to play it. So my friend keeps telling me about his gadgets and his computer. He has a lot of space, or graphic card for game performance. And yeah, that's basically it. And also, there's another friend who sits in front of him who also talks a lot about gadgets that men talk about. Yeah.
So the men are always on their phones. You might have done this in an essay earlier.
Yes. So I'm gonna talk. So this was about 2 years ago.
Yeah.
You read this, so for my essay.
I haven't read it yet, but
So this was 2 years ago. I went to a competition in the district. It was all my gifted classmates. So it was there. None of my classmates were there. I'm the only one in my class.
Mm-hmm.
So first I was really nervous because there was no friends. There was none of my classmates that I'm really close to. But over time in the gifted class, I made a few friends. They're not the best. I didn't really make like too close to them, but he was okay with me. And before the competition, my dad was there. And then he was like, Obi-Wan Kenobi, and told me that calm down, you know, when you do the test. So my head was just getting fresher and fresher when I met one of my classmates in this center. So yeah, my head was really frustrated. And then when I walked into the room, the test room, and started doing the tests. At first, we do the listening test. I almost slept between every single listening because it was too long.
It was?
Yeah, it felt like an hour. But I did. What?
Dramatic. What tip would you give?
So, I would give that that before the day before you go to the test, you'll receive a baton.
Yeah.
And so won't sleep between in the test or between every single listening test. And calm down when you do the test, because if you don't, you'll fail.
And you learned a lot.
Yeah, a lot. It was my first time going to a district position.
And how did you do?
Good.
Well,
I got a third prize.
Awesome. Well done. So choose one scenario.
Choose two, because that's the thing that I've done the most.
I'm glad. What is number two?
So, when I stayed at my friend's house, it was actually my first time. Well, I wouldn't really call it first time, because I stayed at my cousin's house a lot before I went to my friend's house. So when you stay in your friend's house, listen to their parents, because if their parents see you as a bad guest, then they will see your parents, how your parents educate you. And number two, don't shout a lot. use your voice that people can hear. And
be polite.
Yeah, be polite.
And what happens when you leave?
Say goodbye.
Yeah.
And yeah, that's all. Yeah.
Thank you. Awesome. Well done. That's it.